हेलो माय स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम टू माय चैनल एंड वेलकम टू माय टुडेज टॉपिक। टुडे आवर टॉपिक विल बी ऑन कंप्यूटर नेटवर्क। ऑलरेडी इन क्लास 8 यू हैव लर्नड अबाउट कंप्यूटर नेटवर्क। व्हाट इज नेटवर्क, व्हाट इज कंप्यूटर नेटवर्क, डिसएडवांटेज, एडवांटेज एंड ऑल द रिलेटेड टर्म्स एंड फैक्टर्स। Today in your class you will have a broad idea. Okay, let's start today's topic. Okay, so today your topic is computer network. Okay, so go to the next slide. So the first question is, what is computer network? You know, the network is a collection of devices. Okay, so here if the question is computer network, then the answer will be computer network is a collection of computers that are connected with each other with transmission media for the purpose of data sharing, communication and sharing of computer resources. So here all the terms are there. Number one is communication, sharing of computer resources, transmission media. Okay, so one by one we'll give the topic to you. Okay, so go to the next slide. Uses of computer network. What are the uses of computer network? The points are given below. Number one is resource sharing. So one important advantage of computer network is we can share the resources. That means computer resources. Okay, like suppose printer, okay, and programs, data. Okay, you can share all the resources. Number two point is a server client model. So what is server client model? You know, server means a central computer which is used to store the information. Okay, and what do you mean by client? Client means end users. You can think yourself as a end users. So we are the client. We send request to the server and then server send us the response. Okay, so here one important use of computer network is server client model. Next part is communication medium. So computer network behaves as a communication medium among the users. Okay, by using the network we can communicate with each other. Okay, by chatting, video conferencing or any type of method. Now the next point is e-commerce. What is the use of e-commerce here? In e-commerce, computer network is also important. Okay, why? Because we can do the business over the internet, to sell the product, buy the product or anything. Okay, so computer network is also important in business also. We can business over the internet. Examples, Amazon's, Flipkart's and so on, you know very well. So basically e-commerce means electronic commerce. Okay, if you do the commerce using the electronic medium, here it is computer or any type of gadgets like laptop, Android phone, that means mobile phone. Okay, and the last point is flexible networking environments. So what do you mean by flexible networking environments? In network system, employees can work at home by using office computers through networks. If you are at home and you are unable to go to the office, okay, still you can do all your works sitting at your home. How you can use the network? Okay, so I think this slide gives you a concept about the uses of the computer network. Okay, now go forward. So here we learned about the components of computer network. So what are the components of computer network? Number one is NIC. That is the important part. So what is NIC? We'll learn later. Okay, but what is the full form? Network interface card. So first part is, or first component of the network is NIC. Okay, network interface card. Second one is modem. Okay, already you are pretty much familiar about all these terms. Next one is router. Next, cables and connectors, then switches, then hub. Okay, so all these four components are important part of the computer network. So go to the next slide. So now the question is, what is NIC? So NIC is a interface card. Okay, so NIC is a interface card, that is called network interface card. Okay, so here it is not national, it will be network. Okay, network interface card. So what is NIC? It is a device that helps the computer to communicate with another device. Okay, so NIC means network interface card, that is used to connect one computer to another computer. Got it? Next part is hub. So what is hub? Hub is a central device that splits the network connection into multiple devices. So this device is responsible to split or break the network connections into multiple devices so that all the devices can join in any network. Next point is switch. Next point is switch. What is switch? Switch is a network device that group all the devices over the network, okay, to transfer data to another device. So this device basically groups all the devices over the network. Okay, next part is router. Sorry, what is router? Router is a device that connects the LAN to the internet. So what is the main purpose? Its main purpose is connect the LAN to the internet. We know internet means wide area network. Okay, wide area network. And what do you mean by LAN? Local area network. Okay, so router basically connects these two types of network. Okay, the router is mainly used to connect the distinct networks or connect the internet to the multiple computers. Distinct networks means different types of networks. So router basically is used to connect distinct or different networks or connect to the internet to multiple computers. Next part is modem. What is modem? Modem connects the computer to the internet over the existing telephone line. A modem is not integrated with the computer motherboard. A modem is not integrated with the computer motherboard. It is not installed on the computer motherboard. It is a separate part. A modem is separate part on the PC slot found on the motherboard. So take a look of all this picture. So it is the picture of hub. It is network interface card. Here it is national, it will not be national, it is network interface card. Here it is switch. Here it is modem. And here it is router. So you can find all the devices here already learned in the previous slide. Take a look of it. Okay, go to the next slide. So it is the working of hub, router and switch. So router is connecting two computers, okay, and this hub connects all the devices or the PC, personal computers. So here you can see that hub connects all the computers together in a network, and switch also connects all the computers in a network, okay. And router is responsible to connect two different computers that are on the different network, okay. This computer is connected to this switch, this computer is connected to this hub, okay. So this computer is connected to this network and this computer is connected to this network. So basically routers connects two networks. Yes, got that? But here is the difference between hub and switch. Later on we will be discussing on that part, okay. So going to the next slide. Now we are about the cables and connectors. So the question is, what is cable? Cable is a transmission media that transmits the communication signal, okay. So when you are in the network, it is mandatory that you should have a type of media, that means transmission media, so that you can transmit the communication signals over the network. So cable is the responsible to transmit the data communication signals, okay. So what are the types of the cables and connectors? The first part is twisted PR cable. It looks like that way, twisted PR cable, okay. Here is the twisted part, okay. So it is a high speed cable that transmits the data over 1 Gbps or more. So 1 Gbps means this is the rate of transmission of data, 1 GB per second, okay. So here look at the picture. It is the twisted PR cable, okay. And here is the diagram. You can watch the diagram here. Next kind of cables is coaxial cable. In our cable line we can see that. So coaxial cable resembles like the TV installation cable. It is more expensive than twisted PR cable, but it provides the high data transmission speed. So in coaxial cable, the transmission speed is greater than the twisted PR cable, okay. So here is the diagram and all the parts are there, okay. So center conductor is there, this is dielectric part, the shield, this is foil shield, this is braided shield, and this is the outer layer, okay. Now fiber optic cable. So what is fiber optic cable? It is a high speed cable that transmits the data using the light beam, okay. So it uses light beam to transfer data. It provides high data transmission speed as compared to the other cables. It is more expensive as compared to the other cables. Okay. And the nowadays it is very much popular and it is used everywhere for high speed data connection. Got it? Okay, go to the next slide. So now we'll be learning about the features of the computer network. What are the features? Number one is communication speed. Okay, so network provides us the fast and efficient communication speed. We can do video conferencing, we can do email messaging, etc. Okay, so the first feature of this computer network is communication speed. So network provides us to communicate over the network in a fast and efficient manner. Example, video conferencing, email messaging, etc. Okay. Number two is file sharing. Computer network provides us to share the files with each other. Number third, backup and rollback is easy. The files are stored in the main server, which is centrally located. Okay, therefore it is easy to take the backup from the main server. Okay, so this is very important part. If you want to store the data forever, so we need to make it as backup. Okay, so we can backup all the data and files, and also you can roll it back. Next point is software and hardware sharing. The user can access the application centrally, so we don't need to install the software on every machine. Okay, so whenever you are on the network, it is not important that you have to install all the softwares on every machine. You can access the application centrally. Okay. Next part is security. Network allows the security by ensuring that the user has the right to access the certain files and applications. That means you will be provided with a password. Okay, network security. Then reliability means that we can add new components on the network. Okay, network must be scalable so that we can extend the network by adding new devices. So whenever we need to extend our network, we can extend with the new component. That is scalability. And the last part is reliability. What is reliability? Computer network can use the alternative source for the data communication in case of any hardware failure. Okay, that is called reliability. Got it? So remember all the points listed here one by one. Okay, next part. Now the part is architecture. Computer network architecture. So what are the types of computer network architecture? One is peer-to-peer network. One is client-server network. So now we'll be learning about all the points of peer-to-peer network and client-server network one by one, and the diagrams are at the below. So look at the diagram and listen to our points. Okay, number one is, in this network all the computers are linked together with equal privilege and responsibilities for processing the data. okay. So in peer-to-peer network, each computer will have equal privilege and responsibility for processing the data. Number two, peer-to-peer network is useful for small environment, usually up to 10 computers. Okay. So look at the picture that here are all the computers are there. But there is no server. So server is absent here. So all the execution or all the sharing of resources are within the individual computers. Okay. Now come to the client server network. The first point is the end users called clients. Already we know we are the clients. You can think it to access the resources such as songs, video, etc. from a central computer known as server. We know we send the request to the central computer, that is server, and server sends us the response. Okay. Number two point, a server performs all the major operations such as security and network management. So security management and network management is done by the server in client server network. Okay. Number third, a server is responsible for managing all the resources such as files, directories, printers, etc. So server manages all the resources that are on the network, files, directories, printer, and anything. The last point is all the client communicate with each other through a server. So here in peer-to-peer network, all the clients can communicate with each other without the server. Here all the clients communicate with each other through a server. So look at the picture. Here server is present. Okay. Clear? So go to the next slide. So now we'll be learning on network types. So what are the network types? A computer network can be categorized by their size. Mainly four types. One is LAN, local area network, PAN, personal area network, MAN, metropolitan area network, WAN, wide area network. Okay, this is the types of computer network. Now we'll be learning one by one. So listen carefully. So here is the picture of LAN, local area network, within a building. So now look at the points one by one. So LAN means local area network. So the first point is local area network is a group of computers connected to each other in a small area such as building, office. Okay, so if you want to connect the computers within a small area such as building, office, then you need local area network. Number two, LAN is used for connecting two or more personal computers through a communication medium such as twisted cable, coaxial cable, etc. Okay, so you need these types of cables to communicate or to make the network, establish the network. Number three, it is less costly as it is built with inexpensive hardware. Okay, so LAN uses hubs, Ethernet cable, network adapters, so that it is less costly to build this type of network. Okay. Next point is the data is transferred at an extremely faster rate in local area network. So in local area network, the data transferred is at an extremely faster rate. Okay. Next point, local area network provides higher security. Okay, as it connected in a small area, so the security is higher in this type of network. Okay, got it. Go to the next slide. Now it is the PAN, personal area network. So it is the picture of personal area network. Okay, so what are the points of personal area network? Number one, personal area network is a network arranged within a range of 10 meters. Okay, this type of network arranged within an individual person, whenever the person uses Bluetooth, okay, or using the Wi-Fi, you can say it. Okay, so Bluetooth, infrared are examples of PAN, that means personal area network. Number two point is, personal area network is used for connecting the computer devices of personal use. Okay, number three, Thomas Zimmerman was the first research scientist to bring the idea of the personal area network. Okay, so remember the name of the person. Next, personal area network covers an area of 30 feet. As already I told you, example of Wi-Fi, Bluetooth, infrared. Okay, and the last part is, personal computer devices that are used to develop personal area network are the laptop, mobile phones. Okay, I think it is clear. Go to the next slide. Now it is the part of a metropolitan area network, or MAN. So a metropolitan area network is a network that covers a larger geographical area. So LAN covers the smaller area, PAN covers the maximum distance 30 feet, then MAN comes and it covers a larger geographic area. Okay, but the method is, it covers by interconnecting the different LAN to form a larger network. Okay, so this point is important. Okay, now look at the picture. This is type of LAN, this is type of LAN, this is LAN, and this is type of LAN. So metropolitan area network joins all the LANs and makes a larger geographical area. Okay, next point, government agencies use MAN to connect to the citizens and private industries. Okay, as metropolitan area network connects all the LAN on the network, it covers the bigger geographical area on the network. Okay, third point, in MAN, various LANs are connected to each other through a telephone exchange line. So how it is connected to each other? Using the telephone exchange line. And the last point is, it has a higher range than local area network. Okay, so MAN, or the metropolitan area network, is greater than the LAN. Okay, next slide. Now the part comes for the WAN. WAN means wide area network. Okay, wide area network. So it is the example of WAN, diagram of WAN. Okay, it is a network, it is a network, it is a network, and WAN, that is wide area network, covers all the networks. Okay, and makes the larger geographical network. So it is a wide area network that extends over a larger geographical area, such as countries, states. Okay, So basically it uses fiber optic cables, satellite links or telephone lines to cover the larger geographical area. Next point, it is a quite bigger network than the LAN, obviously. So LAN is small than MAN and then WAN comes. So WAN covers the large geographical area than LAN and MAN, okay, and also PAN. Number third point, the internet is one of the biggest WAN in the network. So internet is the example of one type network, okay, that is the biggest network. Number four, this network is widely used in the field of business, government and education, okay, clear. Go to the next. Now the part is topology. We know what is topology. Topology is the structure of the network, okay. So the definition is, topology defines the structure of the network, how all the components are interconnected to each other. Okay, so there are two types of topology, physical and logical topology. Now we are talking about the physical topology. So what is the physical topology? Physical topology is the geometric representation of all the nodes in a network. Okay, so how all the nodes in a network are represented geometrically, it is the physical topology. So what are the types of the topology, physical topology? Basically, number one is bus topology, number two ring topology, three hybrid, star topology, mesh topology, tree topology. Six topologies are there in physical topology. Okay, so we'll be learning one by one, okay, on the next slide. So look at the picture also for better understanding purpose. So look at the picture, you will get the idea, okay, how the data is transferring from one point to another point. Okay, so what are the points of bus topology? In bus topology, all the stations are connected through a single cable known as the backbone cable. So what is the backbone cable? This part is called backbone cable, because all the stations or all the nodes are connected through this single cable, so that it is called backbone cable. Okay, next point, when a node wants to send a message over the network, it puts a message over the network. All the stations available in the network will receive the message whether it has been addressed or not. Okay, so because all the nodes are connecting to this single cable or the backbone cable, so any message transferred over the network comes to all the parts. Okay, next point, the configuration of the bus topology is quite simpler as compared to the other topologies. So it is the simplest type of the topology. Next, the backbone cable is considered as a single lane through which the message is broadcast to all the stations. Okay, so using this cable, the message is going all the nodes. Okay, the most common access method, the most common access method of the bus topology is carrier sends multiple access. Okay, so because here on single cable there are multiple points are there or nodes are there. Okay, all the computers or all the devices are connected to this single cable. So If this cable is not working properly, or the total system will be down. Got it? All the computers are connected or devices are connected to this single cable. If any device is not at its work or in the bad condition, then total server will be down. Total network will be down or shut up. Okay, go to the next slide. Here is the picture of network, picture of ring topology, how it works. So this topology is like a bus topology but with connected ends. Okay, what do you mean by that? If you go in the previous slide, you look like that there are two end parts, one is there and one is there. Okay, and all the nodes are connected in between that. But here on the ring topology, there is no end part. So ring topology is like a bus topology but with connected ends. Number two, the node that receives the message from the previous computer will transmit to the next node. So whatever this computer receives the message, whatever this computer receives, it will transmit to its next computer or the node, and this computer will transfer it to the next. So this flow will be in one direction, that is unidirectional. Okay, that is unidirectional. So data flows in this topology will be unidirectional, in one direction only. Next point is the data flows in a single loop continuously known as an endless loop. Okay, it is a loop, here is the no end, so that's why it is called as endless loop. Next point, it has no terminated ends. Each node is connected to other node and having no terminal point. Okay, next point, the data in a ring topology flow in a clockwise direction. In which direction? Clockwise direction. The most common access method of this ring topology is token passing. So what is token passing? It is a network access method in which token is passed from one node to another. Here it is doing, it is going here. It takes the token and passes it to the next, okay, and making a type of ring. So that it is called ring topology. And you will ask me that what is token? Token is a frame that circulates around the network, or you can say that a token is a set of bits or information basically that goes around the network or circulates around the network. Okay, go to the next slide. Start topology. So look at the picture. In the middle there is a switch or a hub, and it is connected to different devices. Okay, so in start topology, every node is connected to the central hub, switch or a central computer. Okay, so in ring topology, every node is connected to the central hub, switch or central computer. We know the central computer is known as the server, and the peripheral devices are attached to that server are not clients. So you can say that this switch or hub is acting as a server, and all these devices are acting as a clients. Okay, next point, coaxial cable or RJ45 cables are used to connect the computers here. Next point. Hubs or switches are mainly used as connection device in a physical star topology. So in physical star topology, switch and hubs or hubs mainly used. Star topology is the most popular topology in network implementation. Got it? So, okay. Go to the next slide. Tree topology. Look at the picture below, how it works. So what is tree topology? A tree topology combines the characteristics of bus topology and star topology. So basically it is a combination of bus topology and star topology. Okay, already you have learned what is bus topology and star topology. Next point is, a tree topology is a type of structure in which all the computers are connected with each other fashion, hierarchical fashion. Okay, like that. Okay, the topmost node in tree topology is known as root node. Again, the topmost node in tree topology is known as the root node. These are the root node, as all these nodes are the topmost node in this topology, and all other nodes are the descendants of the root node. Okay, so all these are the descendants nodes. Okay, last point is, there is only one path exists between two nodes for the data transmissions, thus it forms a parent child hierarchy. Okay, so you can think these nodes as the parents and these nodes as the child. So it is looks like a parent child hierarchy. Okay, and one important point is that there is only one path exists between two nodes. So one path is there, there is one connection. Okay, so this is basically the type of tree topology. Go to the next slide. This is the type of mesh topology. So what is mesh topology? A mesh topology is an arrangement of the network in which computers are interconnected with each other through various redundant connections. That means, look at the picture very carefully, or this picture. Okay, all the computers are connected to all the computers. Okay, so connections are there for the all computers. Okay, you can, if you think that this is the computer one, it can send or receive the resources to this computer, and it is same for all the computers. So here all the computers are connected to all the computers for sharing the resources. Next point, there are multiple paths from one computer to another computer. Okay. Next point, it does not contain the switch, hub or any central computer which acts as a central point of communication. So here server is missing. Okay, the internet is an example of the mesh topology. So internet or interconnected network uses this type of topology. Okay, next, mesh topology is mainly used for WAN implementation where communication failures are a critical concern. Okay, what that means? Suppose this computer is not working, so it does not matter anything in the network. Why? Because all the computers are here sending the resources. Okay, so this computer sends all the resources to all these computers. Okay, so if this computer is not getting the information, So these computers only not in work, but all the other computers will be fine. Okay, got it? So it is used for the internet type network. Next point is mesh topology is mainly used for wireless networks. Okay. And the last point is mesh topology can be formed by using the formula number of cables needed for this type of topology will be equal to n into n minus 1 total divided by 2. So this is a picture of hybrid topology. Here it is, look at this picture very carefully. Here it is start network, ring network, bus network, and hybrid topology connects all this network. Okay, so it is the architecture of the network that connects different types of network as shown in the picture. Okay, this is the star network, ring network, and this is the bus network. So what are the points? Number one point is the combination of various different topologies is known as the hybrid topology. Number two point is a hybrid topology is a connection between different links and nodes to transfer data. Okay, when two or more different topologies are combined together is termed as hybrid topology. Okay, and if similar topologies are connected to each other will not result in hybrid topology. Okay, when, so what is the conclusion? The conclusion part is when there will be different types of topologies, then it is called hybrid topology. Example, if there exists a ring topology in, sorry, if there exists ring topology in one branch of SBI Bank and bus topology in another branch of SBI Bank, so if we connect these two topologies, then it results in hybrid topology. Okay.